Welcome to another session of Grade 9 Mathematics, Chapter 6, Lines and Angles. Dear students, in this third part of the chapter, we'll discuss in detail the solutions to NCERT Exercise 6.1, Question Number 4, 5, and Question Number 6. Let us quickly get into Question Number 4, which says that in figure X plus Y is equal to W plus Z, then prove that AOB is a line. Kindly observe the figure given over here, and then let's quickly get to the solution.
Dear students, now we have been given that angle XYZ is equal to 64 degrees. And XY is produced to point P, and then we have been asked to draw a figure from the given information. So what I shall do is, I shall try to randomly draw a figure. So XYZ is equal to 64 degree, that has to be mentioned. So let me draw a figure, maybe something like this. Yeah, and let me mention that this is X, this is Y, and this is Z, and this is equal to 64 degree. It has been mentioned in the very first line that XY is produced to point P. Now what does that mean, produced to point P? That means XY has been extended to a point P. This is the meaning of produced to point P. It has been extended to point P. Draw a figure from the given information. Okay, this is what the figure looks like. Now, in the question further, it says that if ray y, so q is not in the picture as it is. Let's read the question further. Ray y q bisects angle z y p. Where is angle z y p? Z y p. So if there has to be a ray y q, it would be something of this kind. Yes, this is how ray yq should be there. In such a way, it has been mentioned that ray yq will bisect angle zyp. So bisect means two equal parts. So if this is x, the other part will also be equal to x. Okay. Now, what I've been asked to find, we have been asked to find, yes, angle XYQ as well as reflex angle QYP. This is something that we have been asked to find. Now, irrespective of how would I get the answer, as my approach was in the previous 5 questions, I would go by what has been given. So, with all the data that has been given, what I can conclude is that the total of these side of the line, this should be how much? Is equal to 180 degree, because XP is a straight line. Yes. So can I mention that for line XP, can I say that 64, yeah, plus x, that is these three angles, okay, will be equal to 180 degree. If that's the case, then 64 is written as it is. X plus x becomes 2x. 2x is equal to 180 degree. 2x is kept as it is. The 64 goes to the other side, becomes 180 minus 64. So I get 2x is equal to 180 minus 64, happens to be 116 degree. Okay, so if 2x is equal to 116, what would be x? X is equal to 116 divided by 2. The 2 goes to the denominator. So what do I get? X is equal to 116 divided by 2. If we carry out, it will be 58 degree. So what did I get the value of x as? 58 degree. So if I mention that over here, this is 58 degree and this is also 58 degree. Now coming back to the question, because I have already utilized the given data and this is where I am standing right now. Now let's get to the question. What has been asked? Find angle XYQ. Where is XYQ? XYQ. This angle is something that we have been asked to find. So this total, and if you could see, this should be equal to 64 plus 58. So therefore, I'll write angle XYQ will be equal to 64 plus 58. Yes? So when you solve 64 plus 58, what do we get? Angle XYQ, yes, is equal to 122 degree. So we have found this. Okay? Now, what else have been we asked to find? Reflex of angle QYP. Where is QYP angle? QYP. And QYP is equal to how much? 58. So, since angle QYP is equal to 58, now as we did in the last question, reflex of angle QYP can be found by subtracting QYP from 360 degree. So 360 degree minus 58 degree, and when you solve it, you get the answer as 302 degree. So we have found what is XYQ, that is equal to 122 degree, and what is reflex of angle QYP, which is equal to 302 degree. So this was solution to question number 6. Dear students, with this we come to the end of exercise 6.1. Please practice all the questions of exercise 6.1 in your maths notebook. You may practice it 2 to 3 times, because the more you practice, the better you will get. This is all for today's session. Take care of yourself until you meet next time with another session. Thank you.
Let us get into question number 5 of NCERT exercise 6.1. The question says, in figure POQ is a line. Ray OR is perpendicular to line PQ. OS is another ray lying between rays OP and OR. Prove that angle ROS is equal to half of angle QOS minus angle POS.
Dear students, as mentioned in the question, we have a figure wherein POQ is a line. So what does that mean? It's a line and the total would be 180 if needed, okay? What else is given? Ray OR is perpendicular to line PQ. Where is ray OR? Here it is. OR is perpendicular to line PQ. Yeah, that is already mentioned over here. So this is 90 degree. Yes, this would also be 90 degree. Okay, that's how POQ is a line and the total happens to be 180. Okay, it further says that OS is another ray. OS, here it is. OS is another ray lying between the rays OP and OR. Yes, it is right. OS is a ray which is between OP and OR. Very clearly mentioned in the figure. Now, the further say that we have been asked to prove that angle ROS is equal to half of angle QOS minus POS. Dear students, let me tell you, this is one of my favorite questions in the NCERT textbook. Now, what have been asked to prove? That ROS, where is ROS? Here it is, ROS. So this angle, yes, should be equal to half of QOS minus POS. Where is QOS? QOS and POS. Yeah, Over here again, I shall not be worried how would I get the answer. Okay. What I shall do is, I shall try to observe angle ROS in different ways. Okay, that is mentioning or writing ROS in different ways. So if you could see, if I could put my hand and close the figure. Yes, so what do I get? I get two angles. Yes, angle 1 and angle 2. So what is it? Angle ROS, yes, plus angle ROQ is equal to the whole. Yes, so what do I get? Angle ROS plus angle ROQ is equal to the whole angle. What is the whole angle? Angle QOS. So that's what I'm going to write. Angle ROS plus angle ROQ is equal to, so these two angles, yes, is equal to the total, and the total is angle QOS. Okay, so that's an observation how I could involve ROS and try to get an expression for ROS. So ROS is something that I have to find, so I'll just keep as it is. Plus ROQ, so let me look into the figure. ROQ, this is already given as 90 degree, so I'll mention that 90 degree is equal to QOS. I don't have a value for QOS, it's not mentioned in the question, so this will also be kept as it is. So if I could solve further and what and try to find what is ROS, I shall write angle ROS. This 90 goes to the other side, so it becomes angle QOS plus 90 goes to the other side, becomes minus 90 degree. So this is my first observation about angle ROS. Can ROS be written in another manner? Yes, if you could look into the other side. Yes, this side. So what do we have? ROS and angle POS. So these two angles when added will be equal to what? Angle POR. Yes, so these two angles when summed up, yeah, when added up, should be equal to the whole angle, that is angle POR. So that's what I'm going to write next. Angle ROS plus ROS plus angle POS, okay, should be equal to angle POR. Now, what I shall do is, in the next step, ROS is something that I have to find, so this is written as it is, plus POS. Is POS given? No, it is not given. So this is also written as it is. POR. POR. Yes, this is given as 90 degree. POR. The total is 90 degree. So I mentioned 90 degree as it is. So as my initial intention was to get different expressions for ROS, I'll proceed with that. ROS is kept as it is. 90 degree, and this angle POS goes to the other side, it becomes minus angle POS. So this is my second observation about angle ROS. So I've got two observations. One is ROS is equal to QOS minus 90. The other one is ROS is equal to 90 minus POS. Now, what I shall do next is add equation 1 and equation 2. So when I add the two equations, what happens is LHS get added with LHS and RHS get added with RHS. So what would I write is angle ROS gets added with angle ROS of the LHS of both the equations, and over here angle QOS minus 90 degree, which is the RHS of the first equation, plus the RHS of the second equation. Okay, Now, ROS plus ROS will give you 2 times angle ROS. So, angle ROS plus angle ROS, 2 angle ROS is equal to, if you could observe here, minus 90 plus 90, they get cancelled out because it's 0. So, what am I left with? Angle QOS, written as it is, minus angle POS. Okay? Now, do I need 2 angle ROS? What do I need? Angle ROS. So, what I would do next is, I'll just write angle ROS. And what would happen with this 2? It goes to the other side and comes in the denominator. So, I'll write it as 1 by 2. And what is left? Angle QOS minus angle POS. So, what do I have? ROS is equal to 1 upon 2 angle QOS minus angle POS. And if you could realize, my dear students, this is something that we wanted. Yes, and we got that by simply observing different expressions of angle ROS. This was solution to question number 5. I hope this is pretty much clear to you. Maybe you can mark this as important question from examination point of view. Now, let's get into the next question.
Now, let us get into question number 6 and the last question of exercise 6.1. The question says, it is given that angle XYZ is equal to 64 degree and XY is produced to point P. Draw a figure from the given information. If ray YQ by 6 angle ZYP, find angle XYQ and reflex angle QYP. Let's get to the solution of this particular question.
Dear students, now in question number 4, as mentioned, we have a figure wherein the given data is that X plus Y is equal to W plus Z. Okay, where is X? Here it is. X plus Y is equal to W plus Z. So that's the given data. And what have been asked to prove? We have been asked to prove that AOB is a line. AOB is a line. So where is AOB? AOB. Yeah, this is a line. Now if you know, if this is a line, yes, X plus Y should be equal to 180 degree, or else the angles on the other side, that is Z plus W, should be equal to 180 degree. That's how we can say that the given set of points make a line. So, if AOB has to be a line, it has to be X plus Y, that is the angles on this side, should be equal to 180, or the angles on this side should be equal to 180, that is Z and W. Now, as I said in the previous cases, all that we do is use the given data. But to begin with, if you know this is a point O and these are the angles around the point O. So what will be the total of these angles? That is angle X plus angle Y plus angle Z plus W. What should be the total? The total of this should be equal to 360 degrees. So that's what I would write here. X plus Y plus W plus Z should be equal to 360 degree. Should be equal to 360 degree because it is sum of all the angles around a point. So this is a point O and around these angles X, Y, Z and W, the sum should be equal to 360 degree. So I've written it already. Now use a given data. What is the given data? That X plus Y is equal to W plus Z. So, I'll write this X plus Y as it is. Now, all that I'm saying is, can I mention or can I replace W plus Z and write x plus y instead of that. So over here, since it is already given that x plus y is equal to w plus z, what I shall do over here is w plus z, yes, will be replaced by x plus y. So instead of w plus z, I'll write x plus y, which is equal to 360 degree. So if you could observe here, x plus x, it is 2x, plus y, it is 2y, is equal to 360 degree. Now if you could see, I can take 2 common to both the terms. So I may write 2, and then in the bracket, x plus y is equal to 360 degree. So what do I get? X plus y is equal to, what would happen with this 2? This is 2 into x plus y, right? So when this 2 goes to the other side, yes, what does it become? It goes to the division. So 360 divided by 2. So what do I get? X plus y is equal to 180 degree. Yes? Now, if you could see x plus y, yes, what did we get? That is equal to 180 degree. So this is what we needed in the beginning. As we discussed, either get x plus y or w plus z, either of them to be equal to 180 degree. So since this on the one side of the line, that is x plus y, is equal to 180, I can conclude that this is possible only when AOB is a line. Yeah, so we got a straight angle. So this was solution to question number 4.